Hello, this is third part of chapter 11 work and energy from the CBSE class 9 NCERT book. My name is Avantika. I hope you have seen the first two parts before this because we have spoken about work and the concept of work and energy and the different types of mechanical energy, kinetic and potential. So if you haven't, then you will not understand what we are going to be talking about now. Therefore, it is required that you see them in order. If you already have, please keep your books open and let's proceed. So this is what we have learned in part two. We have learned that there are various forms of energy and that mechanical energy can be either kinetic or potential energy. An object in motion possesses kinetic energy due to its motion. An object of mass m moving with a certain velocity v has kinetic energy half mv square. The energy possessed by a body due to its change in position or shape is called potential energy. It is the stored energy in it. Okay, the gravitational potential energy, please remember we have only spoken about gravitational potential energy of an object of mass m raised through a height h from the earth's surface is given by mgh. Okay, so first we are going to talk about whether different forms of energy are interconvertible, right? How do green plants produce food? We know that green plants, when exposed to the solar radiation, they produce some amount of food, which is chemical energy. So where do they get their energy from? They get their energy from the sun in the form of light energy, and they use that through various mechanisms in their cells, in their chloroplasts. They chloroplast and mitochondria, they convert it into chemical energy, into different forms of energy. Okay, why does the air move from place to place? The air moves from place to place because there is a potential difference, right? There is a difference in the pressure from high pressure to low pressure. So it is basically just a high pressure area means the temperature is high, the air has a lower density. It moves from a lower density to a lower temperature area. That is the movement of air. Okay, how are fuels such as coal and petroleum formed? Coal and petroleum are formed by years and years, millions of years of compression. This was, what was coal before? Coal was basically wood that from various fossils. Why are they called fossil fuels? Because they came from fossils many millions of years ago. These things got trapped inside the earth, and therefore over millions of years they have changed their form from that to like coal or petroleum, which have that energy, which have a chemical energy that can provide us with for some other kind of energy. Okay, what kind of energy conversion sustain the water cycle? What kind of energy conversions? There is solar energy, which it irradiates the sea, water vapor goes up and then it comes down in the form of rain. So what kind of energy conversions? There is light energy, there is heat energy, there is potential energy, there is kinetic energy, there is wind energy that moves it from place to place. What is wind energy? It is also kinetic energy. Okay, identify in each activity or gadget the kind of energy conversion that takes place. Now you have, if you have some activity like you are running somewhere, or so what happens when you run? You shift, you change the chemical energy in your body into kinetic energy. Okay, what is in the gadget? What do you do in case of, for example, your mobile phones? What do? You have chemical energy in the form of a battery, and that you turn into light energy. For example, you can see it on the screen, right? So different kinds of energy conversions take place in day-to-day life. Okay, for example, when you are watching TV, or when you're watching this video right now, what have you done? I have been speaking it, so what, my sound energy gets transferred into this as electrical energy, which comes to you back as sound energy and as light energy. So there are various kinds of conversions that take place. You will see when the light bulb goes on, you switch it on, there is electrical energy which gets converted into light energy. Or when the fan is working, light energy, electrical energy gets converted into kinetic energy, right? So all of these things is, all these things happen because there is a conversion of energy. If there was no conversion of energy, the world would not move. Firstly, the first thing that would not happen is solar energy would not get converted into chemical energy and life would not exist. So that is the basic thing, that is the basic conversion of, interconversion of energy is the absolute basic requirement for any kind of nature to take place. Nature, even universe, needs to, the way it exists is because interconversion of energy can take place. Okay? So we come to law of conservation of energy. So we know now though that energy can be converted. But when the energy is converted from one form to the other, the total energy remains unchanged. Total energy remains unchanged. It can convert into various different forms. When you are switching on the fan, for example, there is a kinetic energy, but there is also certain sound. So there is a certain amount of electrical energy that is also getting converted into sound energy. But all of these energies remain conserved. आपने उसको जितनी एनर्जी दी, इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी, उतनी पूरी यूज हो रही है. ऑल ऑफ दैट इज बीइंग यूज्ड अप इधर एज काइनेटिक एनर्जी और एज साउंड एनर्जी. एंड दैट काइनेटिक एनर्जी, व्हाट डज इट डू, वेयर डज दैट एनर्जी गो? नाउ दैट काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द फैन, ऑफ द मूवमेंट ऑफ द फैन, गेट्स कन्वर्टेड इनटू काइनेटिक एनर्जी ऑफ द एयर. ऑल ऑफ दीज थिंग्स आर converted, but the total energy remains unchanged. Please remember, energy can neither be created nor destroyed. It can only be changed from one form to the other. Energy can neither be created nor destroyed. It can only be changed from one form to the other. Where have you seen this before? Law of conservation of mass. Mass can neither be created nor destroyed in a chemical reaction. It can only change from one compound to the other, for example. Similarly, energy can neither be created nor destroyed. It can only be changed from one form to the other. And this makes it much easier for us to calculate, to do numericals, to calculate energy. Okay? The total energy remains constant before and after transformation. And it is valid in all situations for all kinds of transformation. आपके पास जितनी energy है body में to do work, उतनी ही आप work कर पाओगे. If you don't eat food, you don't have the energy to do work. You don't have the ability to do work, the capacity to do work. If you don't eat for a few days, you are lethargic, you are tired because your body has no energy to do any kind of work. If you eat well, you have the energy to do work. So this is the basic concept. Unless you have energy given to you, you cannot do work, right? But this also means that energy remains constant. You cannot make energy where there was no energy before. Okay? So it is valid for all situations, in all transformations, universe mein har jagah. This is law of conservation of energy is always applicable. If an object of mass m falls from a height h, the potential energy at the beginning of is mgh, right? At a height h, you know that it is mgh, right? Because as a matter of the height and the mass and the gravity. So gravitational force acts downward, height, gravitational force is acting downwards. You're doing some work to put it to height h, going against gravity, therefore there is a certain amount of work that is being done which gets stored as potential energy. But when it is just standing there, right, then the potential energy is mgh, but there is no kinetic energy because it is just standing there. Okay, but as the object falls, potential energy keeps decreasing due to decrease in height, but kinetic energy keeps increasing due to increasing velocity due to acceleration. You know that when an object is falling, there is a constant acceleration acting on it, which is acceleration due to gravity, g. When, because of this acceleration due to gravity, the velocity keeps increasing. So when an object is falling from a height, the kinetic energy keeps increasing. But because the height is decreasing, the potential energy keeps decreasing. Interconversion हो रहा है. जो potential energy stored थी object के अंदर, now that is getting converted into kinetic energy. There is no new energy that is being formed. There is no energy that is being destroyed. It is the same energy which is getting shifted from potential energy to kinetic energy. Okay. The kinetic energy is given by half mv square, and when the object reaches ground, height is zero and v is the highest just before a moment before it touches the ground, it has highest velocity. You also know that when an object is thrown up, this is also another example. When the object is thrown up, what happens? Because of acceleration due to gravity, the velocity keeps decreasing. Velocity keeps decreasing. When an object is thrown up, velocity keeps decreasing, but height keeps increasing, which means potential energy keeps increasing. जब आप किसी चीज को ऊपर फेंक रहे हो, potential energy increase होने लगती है, kinetic energy reduce होने लगती है. At the highest point of its, when it is thrown, velocity becomes zero. It is at that point that the entire kinetic energy gets. Kinetic energy कहाँ से आई थी? You had given it a certain energy, you had done a certain amount of work to throw it up. Therefore, it had got some kinetic energy, and this kinetic energy keeps getting decreased as the height increases. It gets converted into potential energy. At this highest point, the velocity is zero. Therefore, kinetic energy is zero, and potential energy is the highest. From this point, when it starts to come down, the height starts to reduce, velocity starts to increase, therefore the same energy gets transferred from potential to kinetic energy. And at the point which is just before it hits the ground, if when it hits the ground, then the energy gets transferred to the ground, therefore we cannot talk about that. Just before it touches the ground, it has the highest velocity. Therefore, all potential energy has got converted into kinetic energy. Okay, when height is zero. So the potential energy is now zero and the kinetic energy would be maximum. But the sum of potential energy and kinetic energy at each point remains the same. Jaise yahan pe velocity, in this case, when the velocity decreases, therefore, at the same time the height is increasing, therefore kinetic energy jitni decrease ho rahi hai, potential energy utni hi increase ho rahi hai. So kinetic energy and potential energy at both, at each and every point, is the same. And as the object comes down, the velocity keeps increasing, but the height keeps decreasing. Therefore potential energy is getting converted into kinetic energy. The sum of both potential energy and kinetic energy remains the same. Therefore, potential energy plus kinetic energy remains constant. Okay, there is no change in potential energy and kinetic energy, it remains the same. Okay, आप उसको जितना potential energy दोगे, उतना ही उसका kinetic energy रहेगा. The amount of kinetic energy you give is the potential energy that it will achieve. Do you understand how you do it? If you take an object and you put it at a height, it will fall. It is the height, the potential energy that you give it, that gets converted into kinetic energy. The higher the height, the higher the potential energy, the higher the kinetic energy. Okay. At the same time, if you give some body a certain kinetic energy initially and throw it up, it reaches a certain height where the potential energy is the highest and kinetic energy is zero. But then it comes down with the same principle, where potential energy gets converted into kinetic energy. It remains constant. At the same time, it remains constant. Okay, आप जितनी पोटेंशियल एनर्जी दोगे हाइट पर रखने के बाद उतनी ही काइनेटिक एनर्जी होगी, एंड आप जितनी काइनेटिक एनर्जी दोगे उसको उछालने में ऊपर उतनी ही उसकी पोटेंशियल एनर्जी रहेगी, उतनी ही उसकी नीचे आने की काइनेटिक एनर्जी रहेगी। एट एवरी सिंगल पॉइंट इन दिस जर्नी गोइंग फ्रॉम अप टू डाउन और फ्रॉम डाउन टू अप टू कमिंग बैक, द पोटेंशियल एनर्जी एंड द काइनेटिक एनर्जी का सम, द सम ऑफ बोथ ऑफ दीज एनर्जीज रिमेन्स द सेम, इट रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट। Therefore, potential energy and kinetic energy are constant. This is the total mechanical energy of an object. The total mechanical energy of an object remains constant. These are both mechanical energies, right? So, the total mechanical energy remains constant. Okay? Do you see this? This is the total mechanical energy, like I told you. So sum is the total mechanical energy which remains constant. Okay, using that principle we are going to solve a question. An object of mass 20 kg is dropped from height 4 meter. Fill in the blanks for values of potential and kinetic energy. Take g to be 10 meter per second square. Now it is very simple. What do we do? An object of mass 20 is dropped from a height of 4. We have been given m, we have been given g, we have been given h. Okay, now we calculate the potential energy of when it is at 4 meter. What is the potential energy when it is at 4 meter? Mass is 20, g is 10. We have been told to take g 10. Okay, g 10. Height is 4. Therefore, 800 joule. So here it is 800. Kinetic energy is zero because at the initial it was zero. So total energy is 800. Now it comes to height 3, it is falling down. Okay. We can calculate v square if you want, but you don't have to do that. I'll tell you how. Knowing the law of conservation of energy, you can just calculate the potential energy. It is not PE, it is EP, like this. 20 into 10 into what is the height now? 3. Therefore, it is 600 joule. Kinetic total energy must remain 800. So, what is kinetic energy? 200. If you want, you can also calculate velocity. How will you calculate velocity? You have acceleration, right? And you have gravitational force. So you can calculate velocity, okay? But that will be very complicated because at every point you have to calculate the initial velocity and then you have to subtract the final velocity and it takes a lot of time and you don't know the time. So it is better that you just do it this way. The final energy has to remain constant, 800. Jitni initial potential velocity, potential energy thi. Then you come to potential energy when it is 2, right? So 20 into 10 into 2 meter. At 2 meter, potential energy is 400 joule. At 2 meter, potential energy becomes equal to kinetic energy. How am I getting this value? Ye kinetic energy ki value kahan se aa rahi hai? I am considering that the total energy remains constant. So the initial potential energy was 800. Utni hi energy rahegi puri system ki. It will not move here and there. So EP plus EK, kinetic energy and potential energy ka sum jo hai, it remains constant, which will in this case be 800 joule. So I am calculating potential energy at every point. So 800 mein se utni potential energy minus karke I am getting the value for kinetic energy. Okay. Theek hai? So now we come to next one. 1 meter. 20 into 10 into 1. 200 joule. Subtract 200 from 800. Now it is 600. Okay. Just above the ground. We are considering just above the ground where height becomes 0. If height becomes 0, then this becomes 0. So potential energy is now 0. Kinetic energy is now maximum 800. ओके समझ आया आपको? दिस इज वेरी इजी, इसमें कुछ डिफिकल्ट नहीं है. इट इज बेसिकली ये कम हो रहा है उतना ज्यादा बढ़ रहा है, द मास द टोटल हैज टू रिमेन कॉन्स्टेंट. ओके ठीक है. सो वॉट इज द रेट ऑफ डूइंग वर्क? नाउ वी कम टू समथिंग कॉल्ड रेट ऑफ डूइंग वर्क. देर इज अ लॉट ऑफ रेट ऑफ डूइंग एवरीथिंग. रेट ऑफ चेंज इन वेलोसिटी इज द एक्सेलरेशन. रेट ऑफ डिस्प्लेसमेंट इज वेलोसिटी. इज अ लॉट ऑफ रेट ऑफ डूइंग समथिंग. सो देर इज अ रेट ऑफ डूइंग वर्क. दिस रेट ऑफ डूइंग वर्क इज कॉल्ड पावर. ओके नाउ कंसिडर टू चिल्ड्रन ए एंड बी. Let us say that they weigh the same. So mass is the same for A and B. Mass A is equal to mass B. What do you mean by weigh the same? What is weight? Mg. G दोनों में same ही लगेगा. So weight is the same. So we are only considering mass in this case. Both start climbing up a rope separately. Both reach a height of 8 meter. हाँ, दोनों की potential energy eventually same हो गई because their mass is the same, G is the same, H is the same. But to reach that potential energy, A takes 15 seconds, whereas B takes 20 seconds. Work done by each is the same. What is the work done? MgH. Work done is the potential energy in this case. Work done is MgH, which is the same for both because mass dono ka same hai, G dono ka same hai, H. But A ne 15 seconds mein kiya, whereas B does it in 20 seconds. So who has done more work in a given amount of time? MgH divided by the time. अगर आपने MgH लिया, mass आपको दोनों को पता नहीं है. If denominator is lower, then value is higher, ना? So if A takes 15 seconds, then A has done more work. B takes 20 seconds, denominator has increased, therefore work is more, less. Compared to it, this is the rate of doing work. Rate of doing work. यानि work done दोनों का same है, पर per unit time. यानि sorry, I should write it like this. This is a bit misleading. So work done per time is greater for A, and work done per time for B is less. है ना? So per second A ने ज़्यादा काम किया. Work done, total work done is the same, but per second A has done more work and per second B has done less work. Okay, similarly, a vehicle with more power, this is called power. Rate of doing work is called power. So A has used more power to do that work. Work done is the same, but reduction of time means A has utilized more power. Do that work. B has used less power to do that work. This is the same thing for a vehicle also. If a vehicle has more power, you can do a higher amount of work in a shorter amount of time, or the same amount of work in a shorter amount of time. For example, agar ek vehicle ka, for example, 1200 cc ke car hai. And there is a car of 1500 cc. Using the same amount of effort, आप उसको अगर उतना ही कर रहे हो, this is more power, ना? This has the capability to do more work in a shorter amount of time. Okay? Okay, let's not get into that cc वगैरह. But a vehicle with more power, आप अगर two wheeler चला रहे हो, if you are driving a scooter and if you are driving a car, there is a difference. You will only reach a certain amount of speed with a scooter. You can't reach the same speed as the car. So a car is more powerful. It has the capability to do the same amount of work in a shorter amount of time. आपको journey same ही करनी है. आपको for example 200 kilometer आपको you have to go. But you might take 4 hours. Sorry, 5 hours by scooter. Or you might just take 3 hours by car. So a car has done the same amount of work, right? It has pura 200 kilometer hi kiya hai. It has done the same amount of work, but it has done it in a long shorter time, therefore it is more powerful, right? The speed with which machines change energy or do work is the basis for their classification as powerful. If they are able to do a higher amount of work in a shorter amount of time, they are more powerful, right? This is what you mean by powerful. When a person is more powerful, yani aapka, if you have an elder brother, why I am saying brother is because older brothers generally have more power than you. You can be a girl or you can be a boy. Or if you are small and if you have an elder sister, she might have more power than you, right? So this speed with which the machine, even our body, has more power at a certain stage, therefore we can do more work in a shorter amount of time. Okay, power measures the speed of work done, not the total work done, but the speed of work done and how fast or how slow the work is done. This is power. Power is the rate of doing work or the rate of transfer of energy. Rate of transfer of energy also, because what is work? Work is the change in energy. Change in energy is work. Rate of transfer of energy is also power. Okay? So rate of doing work, if an object does work W in time T, then power is work upon time. P is equal to W upon T. And the unit of power is watt. This is named after James Watt. So the symbol is, okay, this looks like James Bond ka. The name is Watt, James Watt. The symbol is W. Now remember, if you remember, this is also joule per second. Look at this. Aap dekho zara. Power is joule per second. What is joule? Joule is work. Work is joule or newton meter. Hai na? So power is also newton meter per second. न्यूटन क्या होता है? न्यूटन इज फोर्स इज इक्वल टू फोर्स का होता है ना न्यूटन. न्यूटन इज फॉर एफ इज इक्वल टू एम ए. तो न्यूटन का क्या था? किलोग्राम मीटर पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर. नाउ दिस इज सो कॉम्प्लिकेटेड, थिंक अबाउट इट. न्यूटन केजी मीटर पर सेकेंड स्क्वायर इंटू मीटर इंटू सेकेंड. ये न्यूटन का डाला इंटू एम अपॉन एस. So what does it become? Kilogram meter square plus kilogram meter square upon second cube, right? Rate of doing something upon rate of doing something upon rate of doing something. Itna complicated ki wajah ke, that is why it is only W. Okay, so this is why you have different SI units. You don't just derive units from the previous one because it can get very complicated. Theek hai? You can also write joule per second. I think that is generally fine. But don't remember all this. Bahut confusion hai. Okay. So watt is the general SI unit of power. 1 watt is the power of an agent which does work at the rate of 1 joule per second. Theek hai? 1 joule per second. 1 watt is the power when work is done at 1 joule per second. और पावर इज 1 वॉट व्हेन रेट ऑफ कंजम्पशन ऑफ एनर्जी इज 1 जूल पर सेकंड. यहाँ पे कंजम्पशन ऑफ एनर्जी कहाँ से आया? बिकॉज वर्क हैज द सेम यूनिट एज एनर्जी. वर्क का एनर्जी के यूनिट सेम है, जूल. सो कंजम्पशन ऑफ एनर्जी 1 जूल जब होता है पर सेकंड, दैट इज 1 वॉट. सो आइदर वर्क डन एट द रेट ऑफ 1 जूल पर सेकंड और एनर्जी कंज्यूम्ड at the rate of 1 joule per second. Larger rates of energy transfer. Now we are talking about energy transfer because we will talk about commercial energy. So ye hum pankha vagaira chalate, we are using energy. We are not talking about work done. We are talking about consumption of electrical energy, right? So that is why we talk about power being rate of consumption of energy. Rate of work done or rate of consumption of energy is the same thing because work is a change in energy. Right, larger rates of energy transfer can be 1 kilowatt or 1000 watt. Right, we have talked about energy being in terms of kilojoules. Mein in the same way, energy can also be, power can also be 1 किलोवाट और 1000 वाट. द पावर ऑफ एन एजेंट में वेरी विद टाइम. इट डजंट हैव टू पावर डजंट हैव टू बी कॉन्स्टेंट. पावर चेंज हो सकती है. एन एजेंट मे डू वर्क एट डिफरेंट रेट्स एट डिफरेंट इंटरवल ऑफ टाइम. यानी अगर फॉर एग्जाम्पल एट वन गिवन पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम एन ऑब्जेक्ट कंज्यूम 10 जूल्स ऑफ एनर्जी इन 5 सेकेंड्स, इट हैज डन 2 वॉट ऑफ एनर्जी. बट इन द सेम इंटरवल उसने 15 किया तो इट हैज 3 वॉट ऑफ एनर्जी. सो इट कैन बी डिफरेंट. एंड वन एजेंट वन ऑब्जेक्ट इन दिस केस वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एजेंट डूइंग वर्क. They may do work, the same work at different rates and different interval of time. यानी ऐसे भी हो सकता है कि 1 watt, 2 watt के लिए this can have, you can do 20 in 10 seconds, which is basically the same. Or you can have at different intervals of time, you are doing different rates पे कर रहे हो, right? So the concept of average power is used. When you're talking about power, you talk about average power because like velocity. You can say that at we have talked about average velocity is the rate of displacement. So different times pe different displacement can be done in the same interval of time, right? In the same interval of time aap different distance cover kar sakte ho, aapki velocity change hoti hai. Similarly power, when you are using power, when you are shifting the consumption of energy, at one point you can be consuming more energy, at another point you could be consuming less energy in the same amount of time. Therefore power is different at different amounts of time. Therefore the concept of average power is used, where it is the total energy divided by the total time taken. Okay, so these are two examples given in your book. Two girls, each of weight 400 newton, climb up a rope through a height of 8 meter. A and B girl. Okay, girl A takes 20 seconds, girl B takes 50 seconds. So weight has been given. Okay, and height has been given. Mg has been given to you. Weight is Mg, right? And height has been given. So what is the work done? MgH. Work done is the potential energy in this case because they are climbing up, right? So MgH and time taken has been T. So A ki A का पावर इज 400 इंटू हाइट इज 8 अपॉन 20 सेकेंड्स, सो 160 वॉट. एंड फॉर बी इट इज 400 इंटू 8 इंटू 50 सेकेंड्स, देयरफॉर 64 वॉट. देयरफॉर यू कैन इजिली ऑल्सो टेल नॉर्मली इफ यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द पावर इन दिस. बट अगर आपको इसे पूछा गया है कि हु हैज मोर एनर्जी, इफ द वर्क डन इज द सेम, हुएवर टेक्स लॉन्गर टाइम हैज लोअर पावर. ओके, a boy of mass 50 kg runs up a staircase of 45 steps in 9 seconds. What have you been given? Mass is 50 kg. 45 steps in 9 seconds. So time is 9 seconds. 45 steps in 15 means total distance is 45 into 15, which is 675. Or centimeter mein hai na, so 6.75 meter. Okay. So time taken is T. What is the work done? Work done is MgH, which is the potential energy, and time is T, which is 9. So this is total power, 375 watt. So we answer these questions. What is power? Power is the rate of doing work or rate of consumption of energy. Define 1 watt of power. 1 watt of power is when 1 joule of work is done per second, or when consumption of energy is 1 joule per second. A lamp consumes 100 joule of electrical energy in 10 seconds. What is its power? Simple, joule per second, or energy per second. So it is 1000 upon 10 is 100 watt. Okay. Define average power. Average power is the total energy consumed upon total time taken, or total work done upon total time taken. So total energy consumed upon total time taken. Numerator mein total work done bhi ho sakta hai. Total Okay, this is average power. We come to commercial unit of energy. So generally joule is very small and it is inconvenient to express in large quantities of energy. We use something called kilowatt hour. Kilowatt hour, not joule per second. Joule per, what is joule per second? But we use something called kilowatt hour. What is what? What is joule per second? What is kilowatt? 1000 joule per second. ठीक है, kilowatt hour is the energy का unit that is used commercially. What is kilowatt? Kilowatt is what is what? Joule per second. And kilowatt is 1000 joule per second. So when 1000 joules per second are used for continuously 1 hour, it will consume 1 kilowatt hour of energy. Now this is a very big quantity. Think about it, na? So 1000 joules use ho rahe per second, and you are doing it continuously for 1 hour. It is 1 kilowatt hour of energy. Please remember, kilowatt into hour hai ye, not divided by hour. Okay, what remains per second? What ka jo unit hai? It remains joule per second, but it has been multiplied by the number of hours for it which it has been used. So 1 kilowatt hour is the energy used in 1 hour at the rate of 1000 joules per second. 1 kilowatt. Okay, again, what is 1 kilowatt? 1000 joules per second ke rate se agar aap 1 hour chalate ho, to you have used 1 kilowatt hour of energy. Okay, what is this in terms of joule? 1 kilowatt hour is equal to 1 kilowatt into 1 hour. What is 1 kilowatt? 1000 watt. And what is it in second? 3600 second. So now you have to remember what is joule per second, and you have multiplied it by second, so you are getting it in joule ka isme. So watt into second, this is 3.6 into 10 raised to power 6 joules. Do you get it? This is how much it is. 3.6 million joules. 10 raised to power 6 is million. 3.6 million joules of energy are being consumed. Or in terms of lakh, 36 lakh joules of energy is being consumed in 1 hour when you are using 1 kilowatt hour of energy. Per hour. Per second kitna? 1000 joule per second. But 3.6 into 10 raised to power 6 joules per hour. Okay. 1000 joule in 1 second, but 1000 joule into 3600 is equal to 1 hour. Okay, energy used in households, industries and commercial establishments is usually expressed in kilowatt hour, and electric energy used per month is expressed in terms of units. Okay, so 1 kilowatt hour is 1 unit. 1 unit of energy. Aapko agar, if you ever have electricity bills, please just check. Ask your parents also. They will tell you that these many units of energy have been used. What is that much? You have usually like 200 units or so, 100 units. It increases in the summers when you are using air conditioners or fans continuously. It increases in the deep winters when you are using geysers and water heaters, right? So that is, you are using more energy. You are using those many units of energy per month. For example, aapko monthly billing hota hai to. So that unit, 1 unit is 1 kilowatt hour. This is an example. An electric bulb of 60 watt, power is 60 watt, is used for 6 hours per day. Calculate the units of energy consumed in 1 day by the bulb. So firstly, you have to convert this into kilowatt, because the energy is kilowatt hour. So 60 divided by मेरा गला दुखने लग गया, 0.06 किलोवाट यूज्ड 6 आवर्स पर डे, इट इज 0.01। ओके, ओ सॉरी सॉरी, व्हाट डिड आई डू, व्हाई डिड आई डिवाइड इट, दैट इज योर प्रॉब्लम, सी डोंट डिवाइड इट, दिस इज 0.06 किलोवाट एंड यू आर यूजिंग इट फॉर 6 आवर्स, यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय 6 आवर्स, देयरफॉर इट इज, यस सी लुक हियर, 0.36 किलोवाट आवर और 0.36 यूनिट्स। ओके, दिस इज हाउ यू कैन, डोंट डिवाइड, मैंने वो गलती आपके सामने की, डोंट डिवाइड। ओके, सो 60 वॉट यू हैव टू कन्वर्टेड इन टू किलो वॉट एंड देन यू हैव टू मल्टीप्लाई इट बाय द नंबर ऑफ आवर्स इट इज बीन गिवन। देयर आर सम थियोरेटिकल क्वेश्चंस दैट आई वुड लाइक टू सॉल्व। लुक एट द एक्टिविटीज लिस्टेड बिलो, रीजन आउट वेदर और नॉट वर्क इज डन इन द लाइट ऑफ योर अंडरस्टैंडिंग ऑफ द टर्म वर्क। Suma is swimming in a pond, yes. She is applying some force, she is moving some distance, yes, work is done. A donkey is carrying a load on its back, yes, he is carrying it, he is walking, he is carrying a load, he is exerting a certain force and he is doing some work. But if you are considering only according to the load, then there is no work done on the load. Load pe kuch kaam nahi ho raha hai. Okay, because the load is just here. It is not in the direction of, there is a displacement, the donkey is moving like this, but the work done, load to yahan pe hai na, so he is not doing any work by just carrying it on his back. Okay, windmill is lifting water from a well, yes, it is lifting, so it is some displacement, some force is being used. Green plant is carrying out photosynthesis, no, because it is not, there is no displacement. Okay, एक्चुअली देखा जाए तो देर इज अ डिस्प्लेसमेंट बट दैट इज इन ग्रेट डेप्थ, सो आपको अगर पूछा गया तो आप बोलो नो। एन इंजन इज पुलिंग अ ट्रेन, येस ऑफकोर्स इट इज एक्सर्टिंग अ फोर्स टू पुल इट एंड देयर फोर इट इज बींग, इट इज डिस्प्लेस, देर इज सम डिस्प्लेसमेंट। फूड ग्रेन्स आर गेटिंग ड्राइड इन द सन, नो डिस्प्लेसमेंट फॉर द फूड ग्रेन्स बट देर इज वर्क डन ऑन द वॉटर बिकॉज देर इज अ सर्टन अमाउंट ऑफ फोर्स एनर्जी दैट इज बीन गिवन टू द वॉटर इन द ग्रेन्स। ग्रेन के अंदर कुछ पानी होता है, इट इज गेटिंग इरेडिएटेड बाय द सन, दैट एनर्जी इज कॉजिंग अ फोर्स दैट इज मेकिंग द वॉटर वेपर टू राइज अप, सो देर इज अ डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ वॉटर फ्रॉम द ग्रेन्स बट फूड ग्रेन्स का कोई वर्क नहीं है। ओके, द सेल बोट इज मूविंग ड्यू टू विंड एनर्जी, यस देर इज फोर्स ड्यू टू विंड एनर्जी एंड इट इज मूविंग अ सर्टन डिस्टेंस। An object thrown at a certain angle to the ground moves in a curved path and falls back to the ground. The initial and the final points of the path of the object lie on the same horizontal line. What is the work done by the force of gravity on the object? Zero. Because displacement from the ground is zero. इतना डिस्प्लेस हुआ दैट इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग बट दिस इज वी टॉकिंग अबाउट द फोर्स ऑफ वर्क डन बाय फोर्स ऑफ ग्रेविटी, फोर्स बाय ऑफ ग्रेविटी का वर्क देख रहे हैं। वी आर नॉट टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ मच वर्क वॉज डन टू कैलकुलेट टू थ्रो इट दिस डिस्टेंस, वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट हाउ मच वर्क वॉज डन बाय द फोर्स ऑफ ग्रेविटी। ग्रेविटी का डिस्प्लेसमेंट तो जीरो हुआ ना, इधर से चालू होकर इधर ही वापस आ गया, इट स्टार्टेड फ्रॉम द ग्राउंड इट केम बैक टू द ग्राउंड, the displacement for gravity is zero, therefore work done by gravity is zero, work done by different objects hota hai, you have to consider that there was a work done by you to throw this from this place to this place, right, but from gravity's point of view it is zero. A battery lights a bulb, describe the energy changes involved in the process. Battery hai, chemical energy hai, it gives electrical energy, it gives light energy. हाँ, बैटरी इज केमिकल एनर्जी, लाइट से बल्ब इलेक्ट्रिकल एनर्जी विच गिव्स लाइट एनर्जी, इट ऑल्सो गिव्स अ सर्टन अमाउंट ऑफ हीट एनर्जी बिकॉज द बल्ब गेट्स हीटेड अप। ठीक है, ठीक है, तो व्हाट हैव वी लर्न, वी हैव लर्न दैट लॉ ऑफ कंजर्वेशन ऑफ एनर्जी मीन्स दैट एनर्जी कैन नाइदर बी क्रिएटेड नॉट डिस्ट्रॉयड, इट कैन ओनली बी ट्रांसफॉर्म फ्रॉम वन फॉर्म टू द अदर। the total energy before and after transformation always remains constant. This was the same as in the case of law of conservation of momentum, that the total momentum of the system always remains constant. Energy in nature is found in several forms: kinetic energy, potential energy, heat energy, chemical energy, etc. The sum of kinetic energy and potential energy of the object is the mechanical energy, and it remains constant because as the potential energy decreases, kinetic energy increases, and as the kinetic energy decreases, potential energy increases. Okay. Power is the rate of doing work. SI unit of power is watt. 1 watt is 1 joule per second. The energy used in 1 hour at the rate of 1 kilowatt is called 1 kilowatt hour. It is 1000 joule per second work done for 1 hour. Okay, so there are a few remaining numericals. This video is already longer than I had expected. So please watch part 4 for the remaining questions and numericals. Okay, so if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, share it with your friends, subscribe to our channel and press the bell icon so that you get intimated every time we upload a new video. Okay, so for now, I bid you goodbye. Bye.